Welcome to this episode of Poetry Digest. I am Adaeze M and today I'll be discussing one of Theresa Lola's award-winning poems. To do that, I'd like to run down the bio of this amazing poet briefly. Theresa Lola is a Nigerian British poet. She was born in 1994. In 2017, she was shortlisted for the Best Pop Poetry Prize and the London Magazine Poetry Prize in 2016. She won the Hammer and Tongue National Poetry Slam in 2017 and now the Brunel. She's an alumni of the Barbican Young Poets Program. That's quite a colorful resume for a lady her age. Now, the poem I'll be discussing today is titled My Aunt's Recipe for Cooking Rice. Whoa! I mean, that's really a title, right? Let's start by reading the poem. Step 1. Rinse the starch off the rice. As if the grains are rosary beads and you're praying your husband never goes home with another woman. Step 2. Drain the rice. Let water slide off like sin after baptism. Boil the rice until tender enough to not feel like a rain of bullets from a voodoo recipe. Step 3. Add salt. A plain meal is a forgotten woman. Serve with tomato stew, plantain, and pieces of meat. Note: don't be like those feminists. They invented a word so they can use the knives meant for the kitchen to slice up the faces of men that would have given them a surname. My comments: I took in the recipe like an unholy scripture. The next time I cook rice, I will let the fire keep burning until the pot can't recognize its own face. Wow, that is really an amazing poem. You see, Lola's poem is a beautiful crafting together of words and thoughts. This is because, unlike most feminist poems which are very confrontational, Lola's poem is subtle yet disturbing. It attacks women's subjugation in a calm but apt way. And the metaphors used in the poem are very powerful and they evoke the appropriate images. I mean, who can believe that we can get the societal expectation on women from something as common as the process of rice cooking? That's really something, right? And what's more, the poem is richly garnished with the religious images of Catholic rituals. Now, in the first stanza or step, we see societal expectations on women on how to keep their men. Women are expected to deny themselves of who and what they are just to stop their men from straying into the arms of other women. Like washing starch off rice before cooking, women are expected to wash themselves of their excess, to rid themselves of themselves so as to keep their relationships. Nothing can be more unfair compared to this. And besides, what is rice without its starch? Now, in the second stanza, you see that women are not expected to reserve a part of themselves, but to lose it completely. They are expected to be drained completely, the way sin leaves the soul with the water of baptism. So invariably, women are expected to be void of self, compassionate, meek, soft, and submissive to their spouses, accepting whatever they do without beating an eyelid. In the third stanza, women are advised to not be plain. You can't be plain. A plain meal is a forgotten woman. Wow, that's really a line. A plain meal is a forgotten woman. So, you know, you have to put up with whatever you have to put up with so as to not be forgotten. Like cooking rice, which is not just enough for a satisfactory taste, until same is garnished and spiced up, women are expected to spice themselves up for their men. And lastly, you are reminded to not be like the feminists. That's a no-no. Women can't be like the feminists who go about sharpening their mouths and end up sending away prospective husbands, men who would have given them surnames. Now, how does the poem persona react to this recipe? She chooses to not take her aunt's recipe. She brands it an unholy scripture, and that's really what this is. It's really an unholy scripture. And the problem I have here and the sad truth in this poem is this advice or recipe comes from an aunt, a woman herself. So it means that oftentimes women themselves are the major tools of women's subjugation. And also, the poem succeeds in bringing to the fore certain wrong assumptions about successful relationships. One, for a relationship to work, the woman has to sacrifice herself practically. Two, the woman has to be consciously attractive. She has to take her time to adorn herself, else she may be forgotten. Well, while I agree that there may be some modicum of truth in these assumptions, I still think it is not behoving only on the women to work relationships. I think relationships is a partnership, and every partner in a partnership is expected to bring something to the table. You can't come empty-handed, you have to bring something to the table. So it is fair and simple that both the women and the men make, you know, conscious efforts to make their relationships work. Leave your comments and all suggestions in the comment section below. And please do not forget to subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video. Bye-bye.